Welcome back to my studio. Today I'm working on that old rock building. In the Texas Hill Country, these limestone or Austin stone buildings are cherished. These are just, this old limestone is just a part of Texas history, and all of us Texans just love these old rock buildings. So I'm using mixtures of my mud, which is ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson, and I've added cadmium orange into it, and then white. And all of these mixtures are that same from that combination, just different variations or different proportions of the colors. Like this right here that I'm putting in right now has more of the ultramarine blue in it. And the roof is also mixtures. Well, it's a little bit different. The roof is mainly ultramarine blue plus cadmium orange. And that gives me that nice gray that I've used on the roof. So you can see that using just a limited number of colors, you can get a wide variety of mixtures. Now, up here under the roof, I want this to be a little bit darker because our sun is coming in from the right. So the roof is casting a shadow onto that wall. So that's going to be a little darker. And then this one also casts a shadow down. And these walls, the grout in them is lighter than the actual stone. So I'm painting my stone darker, and then I'll come back in and add lighter variations into that for the grout in between the rocks. I make this, the back of the buildings, a little bit bluer because I want that edge to go back. Remember, blues, cool colors go back, warm colors come forward. So that's, that back edge is going to be cooler or bluer. Coming toward the front, I'm using a little warmer mixture. This has more orange in it. So you can see how that comes forward. And I'm just dabbing color up there because I want a variation of color. Those rocks are not all the same color, so you get a variation in the old stone. There's even some gray in there. Now I'm going to have sunflowers popping up over the building down here, so I want it to get a little darker as it goes down toward the ground. So that's going to be a backdrop for the sunflowers that are catching the sunlight. So I want the main part of the sun to come up into this area. This is not meant to be an architectural rendering. This painting is the old rock homestead of Amanda's and Brian, or Amanda's family. But again, it's not an architectural rendering. I want to get the impression of the building. Of course, I want it to be very, very close, but I'm not going to delineate each and every stone. And this is a painting. This is not an architectural delineation. I mix a little bit more of my blue plus ultramarine light, and I add just a little bit of some of my brown into that, just to gray it, just a little bit, to marry the color with the other colors. So it has some of the mother color of the building in there. That back edge, that tree back there is dry, so that gives me a little rough edge, but that's okay because this is a stone building. Come up here and do the light on my chimney, the light part of the chimney. And I'm going to use my mall stick now. We got this at the Container Store, and this has a hook on the top of it, these poles, it's about 5 foot pole. They're used to take clothes off of a tall rack, like in clothing stores. And we found these at Container Store, my goodness gracious, probably in 1998 or 99. So I don't know if Container Store still has them, but it is just makes a wonderful mall stick. Look at our, again, the back edge of my chimney is made a little bit bluer. Now the lip of the chimney is going to make a shadow that drops down. And then this side of the chimney will also be in the shadow. So I'm using a little bit darker. And then the back edge of that is also going to be a little bluer. Just to make that drop back. I can't even imagine building these buildings when the workers just, they didn't have cranes and lifts and all like we have. You know, they had to have scaffolding and climb back and forth and up and down. My goodness gracious, probably was in that hot Texas summer sun. This building has withstood the years. It was built in the 1840s. And been in Amanda's family since the 1870s. So it's a, boy, if those old walls could talk, wouldn't it be fun to hear the stories they tell? Family gatherings and babies born and growing up, children playing games and just what fun. So I still have some of my cloud color. I want to come back and just clean up this edge on the top of the chimney there. I like to save my colors. Really makes it nice then when I need to go back in and soften edges or just make adjustments. Okay, now we're going to start adding some of the grout. Let me do a little one thing here. I just want to make this darker side of the building. Just a little edge here. Again, that this side's not getting the sunlight, so it's going to be darker. So we're going to have a dark edge there. And actually this stone's going to be a little bit, even though it's in shadow, it's going to be a little bit lighter just because it's getting reflected light bouncing back. It's on the sunny side of the house, so that shadow is going to be a little bit lighter than the shadow on the dark side. Now my grout color, I just come in, and again, I don't want this, I'm not delineating each and every stone. I just want impressions of that stone because this building's quite a distance from us, so you're not going to see each and every grout line. And just give impressions of stones here and there. I'm coming back in and adding some stones of different colors and just give some variation there because that's how that old rock is. The fieldstone. Limestone was variation in colors, so kind of just let your brush dance across the paint. A few different color stones here and there. just can't even imagine again building this by construction methods that they had in that time. And these old buildings, they withstood the test of time, storms and rain and just gorgeous old buildings. So many of them are falling into disrepair. It's wonderful that Amanda's family has restored this building, and they use it for family gatherings, and they're making all sorts of wonderful memories. Bring some of the grout back into this shadow. That gives you a feeling of the stonework. I'll come back in and do a little bit more work on that, but that's basically how I lay in a stone wall. I thank you so much for following along. I hope you'll visit my blog. The address is at the very end of the video. And you just have a wonderful day and happy painting.